you. I will speak in English because unfortunately I don't speak Czech. But you could pick a bubblefish if you meet one. But I try to speak slowly that you can get my speech. So, I speak about mobility transition. This means the transition from using the car for everything to using the car for if you really need it, for the special reasons. And why is this important? And how does the structure compel to this? What has the structure to do with using the vehicle? That I will talk about. And first I invite you to make a mind thing. Your neighbor is maybe 50 centimeters away. If you would need more space for yourself, for example 4 meters in length and 2 meters in width, I mean from the corner to this corner here, just for yourself, how would this audience now be? How big would the room to be? You see it? Every car needs 4 meters in length and 2 meters in wide. I come to you from Germany, and maybe you think Germany is compared with Autobahn. These are the motorways in the Czech Republic, and these are the Autobahn in Germany. So we have really much Autobahn, and we have many companies that produce cars. And we have also some special thing, we don't have any tempo limit, speed limit. In every country in the Europe and world is a speed limit, but not in Germany. And I come to you from Darmstadt. Darmstadt is south of Frankfurt am Main and has 150,000 inhabitants, maybe compared to Pilsen. Has 3 universities, and over the half of all ways under 5 kilometers are driven by car in Darmstadt. So, I want to change this, and I made some things in Darmstadt I want you to tell about, and everything I tell you, you also can do in your city. So how is the structure of streets in Darmstadt? This is a standard residential area, a standard street. The situation is quite normal. So you see here's the pavement. And here's the kindergarten, and the cars park on the pavement. And also here, cars park on the pavement, and you have no chance, if you maybe have a wheelchair, to get to use this way. And here you see a very wide street, but these cars are parking on the pavement. And a very interesting thing, you cannot use the pavement because cars are parked on both sides. And this situation is tolerated by the police. You don't get any ticket if you park like this. So, how wide should the pavement be? And I made a simulator to show the people how wide the pavement should be. And the rules say that the width is 8 centimeters per person for 2 persons using the paveway and 20 centimeters between them. And 50 centimeters to the street as security distance and 20 centimeters to the house. And then we come to a width of 2.50 meters, which is necessary for every pavement. And here you see these 2.50 meters. And if you go into the pavement with the simulator, you enter here and go around. You enter here with 2.50 meters, and then it will get more and more narrow. 1.80 meters, 1.50 meters, up to down to 90 centimeters, which is the normal width in residential areas. And you see that it's not easy. There's maybe a letter on. That's really not easy to use this pavement with a wheelchair. And on at the walls there was a map to show the people where are the most problems in the residential areas. So you see the both sides of some streets, and in green there's no problem, nobody parks on the pavement. In red and orange it's 1.20 meters to 1.80 meters left, but in red it's just 90 centimeters or 1.20 meters, that's too less. So we have really many areas in red and orange. That's a problem, but if I ask the people who live there, they say, well, but where should I park my car? The parking of the cars is in Darmstadt more important than using the pavements. So there was need to do another action. I went to the parked cars and gave them a ticket. And the ticket looked like an official ticket, but it was just a folder to tell them, okay, it's not okay to park on pavement, but it's very okay to park on the street. So what happened when I started this? I got a letter from the government, city government, and they reminded me that I'm not the police, and the police would do his job, which she actually doesn't. And I had to stop it, otherwise I would have to get a real expensive ticket. So it was a pity I stopped it. I had many of these tickets and I threw them away. So I did something else. I changed parking space into parks. Space for people. There's one day a year, it's called Parking Day, where everywhere in the world, parking space is transferred into space for people. And you can sit there and relax and just be. And you'll see it's very nice atmosphere. But 1 hour after the beginning, the police came and said, well, you need a special permission. If you do anything on parking space, except parking cars. And I said, well, I bought a ticket, you know? Then they said, okay, you need a very special permission. It's called Sondernutzungsgenehmigung. And for the next event, it took me several months to get this permission. But I had it. On the same day we made this, we was needing more space. We needed for us 4 meters in length and 2 meters in wide. And then we was walking vehicle and went, or should I say drove, we went to the city, walked, and showed what happened. This is an invention of Professor Knoflacher, which is professor in Vienna. And yes, we went to the area where people are, and here one car plays for 20 pedestrians, the city for the people or for the cars, and we have leaflets. Could people communicate with each other if everybody needed so much space? And then there came a car from below, and he couldn't pass because it was not enough space for everybody of us. And it was a money transporter, and he turned down the window and said, "Hey, I'm a special transport, I have to pass." And we said, "Well, we also are a special transport." And yeah, we just stayed there, and 2 minutes later, the money transporter has had to turn. Okay, this was pedestrian. Also, by bike, going by bike is a very effective way, so maybe the fastest way to go through a city. And so this problem, the photo behind isn't visible. This is the webpage of Critical Mass Prague. And last Tuesday, there was a critical mass. What is this? You are a group of people with bikes and just meet and cruise through the city. And in the group, you are a bit stronger than you are alone. And you follow all the rules, but you are a group. So if the first person runs over the crossing at green, then the whole group follows. Because it's important that a group is one group. And it's very interesting how the people react in their cars. If she has green and group runs and runs on. So we do it every month, and also in Prague every month you can meet there and cruise to the city and see how it is cycling without having fear of the cars, doing earn, and you know it if you go by a bike. Maybe do you have a tempo limit, a speed limit for cars here in Prague? I don't know, because cars here are so fast. So, if you have a bike and it's broken, you have two possibilities. First, you let your bike in the cellar until next summer, or you repair it by yourself. So we have in Darmstadt a repair shop, self-repair shop, where you get the tools, you get instruction, and you get the material. And you just go there and fix your bike and pay what you want. And this is this is done by the students from the Technical University of Darmstadt. And it's always crowded in this room, but because many people have bikes and have no money to repair it professionally. Okay, these are all very, I think, little things for mobility change. We also got one big thing. We have no bypass road around Darmstadt, and that's, I show you the structure here. In red, you see the main roads of Darmstadt, and in blue, you see areas where people live. And planned was a new road, a bypass road, running exactly through the residential areas and then to the autobahn. In a tunnel with 80 million euros of cost. So, we got a very active citizens initiative, and they got Darmstadt's first citizens decision in the history of Darmstadt, and this was in 2009. And in this decision, 55% didn't want the road to be built. And the interesting thing is that here in this area live the people who got less noise, less exhaust from the new road, and they was really against the new road. So, this is a poster from the initiative, avoid traffic instead of generating new traffic. So now I show you something that don't exist in Darmstadt yet, a cargo bike rental. But it exists in other cities like Cologne, and next year we will make it. In Cologne you can get a cargo bike for free for some days, if you need one. And I think that's really good, because often you have not so much to transport that you really need a big transporter. It's enough if you have a little cargo bike. And there's also a booking formula. It just works. So, now the question. Is this mobility transition, or are this just maybe jokes or little peaks? I think these actions raise the awareness for mobility transition, and they give the imagine. You all got an imagine how could it be? And you can only do what you can imagine. We give good examples how it should be. Well, I come from Darmstadt. In Darmstadt, the universal transit pass for students was invented in 1991. And it was first in Germany, and now all over Germany we have universal transit passes. You have your student ticket and can travel everywhere in the area with bus and train. And 42% of all ways in Darmstadt are done by foot or bike. So, and I will return tomorrow to Germany, the inventor of the renewable energy law in the year 2000, with the help of Hermann Scheer from Eurosolar. And it is a country of mobility transition, bottom up. So, if you are interested in our work, you can go to our homepage, verkehrswende-darmstadt.de, or you write me an email. Thanks for listening.